Welcome to another live streaming tutorial. In this video, I'm gonna show you how to go ahead and add a Countup timer inside of Streamlabs so you can start to incorporate this into your stream. Let's go ahead and get started. All right, so once you have your Streamlabs open, the very first step is you wanna make sure that you have the scene selected where you're gonna want to have the Countup timer live. Once you've done that, we're gonna come to sources, we're gonna hit the plus icon, and then we're gonna go ahead and add a text source. So once you hit add source, we're gonna go ahead and label this timer, and then you'll hit add source, you'll hit done, and that's gonna be the first step. The next step is to go into the description of this video and click on the link labeled My Stream Timer. This is gonna bring you to a window like this, where you'll be able to go ahead and install and download the timer, and then once you have it installed, you wanna go ahead and open it up, and then it's gonna look like this, right? You'll be started at the down tab, you wanna scroll over to where it says up, and then you'll see here you can start the timer at any point. I'm gonna leave it at 0 minutes. The output format will leave it at custom, and then the custom output, it's gonna be set to hours, minutes, and seconds. And if you don't want the hours, I'm gonna show you a little hack here in a few moments so we can go ahead and remove the hours without having to upgrade to a pro plan. Then the file name is countup.txt. We'll simply hit copy, you'll hit OK, and then we'll hit start, and we'll minimize this window. Now you wanna come back to Streamlabs, and you wanna go ahead and select timer, then you wanna go ahead and select read from file, we'll paste what we copied and hit browse, and now we wanna select count up, hit open, and now you can see here that the timer is now visible inside of Streamlabs, but it looks blurry. So how do we go ahead and fix that? You wanna take the font size to the max at 288, and that's gonna clear it up and also allow us to be able to resize it without losing quality. Now let's go ahead and customize the timer just a bit to give it a better look and feel. So the first thing I like to do is I like to change the font to impact, like the boldness of it. Then I like to come down and add a gradient. And then I like to go ahead and change the color, and you can change this color to any color that you like. And then I also like to go ahead and add an outline as well. We'll simply hit done, and now you can see that our timer is simply counting up. But I promise you that I'll show you a little hack on how to go ahead and remove the hours without upgrading to a pro plan. So what you want to do is you want to, on your keyboard, select the alt key, and then you'll be able to drag it over until the hours are gone. And now you have the countdown going up. But what if you want to go ahead and create a countdown timer, right? So I personally prefer to utilize a countdown timer that's incorporated into an overlay. Now, what do I mean? It looks something like this. It's an overlay that has a countdown timer already incorporated into it. So if this is something that you're looking for, you can go into the description of the video to streamdesigns.com, where I've created several countdown timer templates that you can go ahead and purchase. But what if you want to go ahead and utilize this timer as a countdown timer that we went and created? Well, you can go ahead and watch this video right here where I show you how to turn this countdown timer into a countdown timer that you can utilize in Streamlabs. I'll see you in the next video.